Thank you, Twyla, for the kind introduction. My name is Ted Pittenger, and I am the founder and president of Samaritan Ministries International. It's a pleasure for me to be the keynote speaker for this event tonight. Now, most of you are probably familiar with the cartoon Calvin and Hobbes. Calvin would sometimes play a game that he called Calvin Ball. In Calvin Ball, there are basically no rules other than the rules made up by Calvin. And the rules could change at any time, basically at Calvin's whim. You might say that the year 2020 is a huge game of Calvin Ball, and someone out there is making up the rules as we go. When Twyla first asked me to be the keynote speaker for this event, I figured I would be in Minnesota tonight, speaking to a room full of people who had just enjoyed a wonderful plated dinner. My, how things have changed. I could share multiple memes and stories about COVID-19 pandemic, but I'll leave you with this image of Calvin Ball. I founded Samaritan Ministries International as an Illinois not-for-profit in 1991. Interestingly, we signed the incorporation papers on September 11, 1991, exactly 29 years before the recording of this video. From 1991 through 94, we worked on the development of the organization, including a false start in 1992. In the fall of 1994, we welcomed our first members, and last year we celebrated 25 years of service to our members. What started out as a mom-and-pop family business in a small office in one corner of a remodeled chicken coop has grown to nearly 400 employees serving members in every state as well as several foreign countries. I was motivated to start Samaritan Ministries because of a time of experiencing no health insurance for our growing family and my experience with another healthcare sharing organization. I became a member of a sharing organization called Christian Brotherhood Newsletter, which later became Christian Healthcare Ministries, who are still going strong today. I was so impressed with the idea of healthcare sharing that I wondered why there couldn't be another organization like CHM. I saw some ways that improvements could be made on how their organization was run, like finding more creative ways to get the word out to those who might be interested in a biblical approach to healthcare, and putting together high-quality printed materials. CHM materials were run off on a mimeograph machine at the time. If you pause for a second, those of you who can remember these can probably still smell the mimeograph ink. I want to assure you that I don't live my life by the fortunes found in Chinese fortune cookies, but I did find this one time and it was a pretty accurate reflection on how I got into this particular endeavor. If you cannot invent, you must improve. I didn't come up with the idea of healthcare sharing, but I did try to come up with improvements. Christian Healthcare Ministries had already been functioning for about 11 years when I incorporated Samaritan Ministries in 1991. I thought we would be the second nationwide organization of its kind, but during that three-year time of setting things up, another organization started up in 1993 and beat us to the market. That organization is MediShare, and they have become the Kleenex of healthcare sharing. We have even heard people say, "Yeah, I use Samaritan Ministries as my MediShare." While I am admittedly biased, I believe Samaritan Ministries is better than MediShare, even if we are the puffs of facial tissue. So by the mid-1990s, there were three nationwide organizations that grew slowly and steadily over the years. So let me tell you a little bit about healthcare sharing. Healthcare sharing is an organized way for people to help one another with medical expenses that functions on a cooperative basis. Healthcare sharing is not insurance, and to distinguish ourselves from insurance, we typically avoid using insurance-type language. This arrangement is not an insurance plan, and we don't want to contribute to consumer confusion by using familiar insurance words. Each participating household is assigned a monthly share amount that they can figure into their budget, and the resources available each month are used to meet the medical needs of other members of the organization. Each organization's unique guidelines spell out what medical needs can be shared and those that cannot. As the three nationwide organizations continued to grow through the early 2000s, we were pretty much content to fly under the radar of government notice. But that all changed with the introduction of RomneyCare. Since Governor Romney and his staff were not aware of healthcare sharing, we were nearly legislated out of existence in Massachusetts. With the election of Barack Obama, we knew that we had to stand up and be counted. Samaritan Ministries and MediShare met together and formed the Alliance of Healthcare Sharing Ministries in 2008 to serve as a trade organization and lobbying vehicle for healthcare sharing. I clearly remember President Obama saying at a town hall meeting, "If you like your healthcare plan, you can keep your healthcare plan." You may or may not think that campaign promise was kept for you, but through what we consider to be a miracle of God, we were able to carve out an exemption in the Affordable Care Act. And the campaign promise was fulfilled, at least to healthcare sharing members. As a result of the exemption in the Affordable Care Act, there have been over 100 organizations that have presented paperwork to be approved as a healthcare sharing organization. The vast majority of those organizations are relatively small, localized religious groups like Mennonite or Amish. A couple other organizations have risen up in recent years, Solidarity, which primarily serves Catholic believers, and Liberty HealthShare. Each group is unique in its particular application of healthcare sharing. And if you have interest in learning more, these are five of the nationwide organizations which I am comfortable encouraging you to investigate and discover what might be the best fit for your household: Christian Healthcare Ministries, MediShare, Solidarity, Liberty HealthShare, and of course, Samaritan Ministries. Some common features of healthcare sharing would include affordability as compared to health insurance. We often find that the monthly share suggested for our members is half or even a third the cost of health insurance. Freedom is a huge feature of healthcare sharing and a great connection we share with the Citizens Council for Health Freedom. I'm so grateful for the work of CCHF and their effort to preserve and protect our healthcare freedoms. On this fundraising night, would you consider giving a generous gift to the work of CCHF? It is an important feature of our organizations to not interfere with the patient-practitioner relationships. We know that this relationship is extremely important to most people, and we don't want to present a barrier or meddle in medical decisions that directly impact your family. The critics of healthcare sharing will say there's no guarantee that medical bills will actually be paid. And this is actually true. Because we are not insurance, we cannot make those assertions. And while past performance is no guarantee for the future, our long history of successfully meeting medical needs speaks volumes about how this has really worked. Each month, the 270,000 individual members in Samaritan Ministries share about $30 million to help with medical expenses. Among the five major healthcare sharing organizations, there are well over a million members sharing $100 million in medical bills each month. While some of the organizations have preferred provider networks, Samaritan Ministries and others provide total freedom for their members to choose their own healthcare providers. One of the hallmarks of healthcare sharing is the care and personal touch that is extended to our members. I believe this is especially true of Samaritan Ministries. As Samaritan, we make a big deal about spelling healthcare as two distinct words. We write out healthcare, not healthcare, because we care about your health. We do care about your health and see it as much more than a sterile generic term that can lose its personal touch. We thought it was so important that we insisted on this when we formed the Alliance of Healthcare Sharing Ministries. Let me share with you a video segment of what one of our members went through with their baby boy and how our staff responded.
We found out Shepherd's diagnosis when I was about 17 weeks pregnant. He has a condition that's called double inlet left ventricle, which is kind of a fancy way of saying he has three chambers in his heart instead of four. And so we learned at that appointment that he was going to need a series of surgeries after he was born in order to give him what they considered a, I guess, normal life is what they were telling us.
We're in need. We were broken.
And we weren't sure how this worked.
Yeah. Very emotional, very, very broken. And as my wife just said, not sure how this worked. And called Samaritan, and they said, you just go have that baby. You leave the rest to us.
And just to hear the confidence on the other end of the phone of, this is not something that you need to be concerned about at all. You focus on the health of your family, the health of your baby, and we will walk with you every step of the way.
Healthcare sharing organizations are about more than just paying medical expenses. We attempt to care for the whole person. Healthcare sharing organizations work on behalf of their members to secure discounts and fair pricing in this age when transparency in medical service pricing is almost non-existent. Healthcare sharing can be utilized as a standalone at age 65 and older, or in conjunction with Medicare. Another feature of healthcare sharing is the sense of community that our members experience. I would like to share another short clip from one of our videos.
I take my responsibility very seriously because I want people to love where they live, and you don't have to go to the store and buy a bunch of things. It's all about what you love and what you want to come home to and what you want to come home and see.
I'm Patrick Birdsong, and I'm a real estate broker and investor.
And I'm Melody Birdsong, and I'm an interior consultant, and we are Samaritan Ministry members.
Thank you for this opportunity to share a little bit about healthcare sharing and the story of Samaritan Ministries. We received some questions prior to the taping of this presentation, and I attempted to answer those questions in the presentation itself. Feel free to give us a call if you have other questions that remain unanswered about healthcare sharing. Of course, we are gathered tonight to support the work of Citizens Council for Health Freedom, and I would ask you to consider making your most generous donation to this excellent work. CCHF is dedicated to protecting our healthcare choices, patient and doctor freedoms, as well as protecting your healthcare privacy. We need your help to continue in these efforts.